Dawson Creek is a city in northeastern British Columbia, deriving its name from the creek of the same name that runs through the community. The creek was named after George Mercer Dawson. Once a small farming community, Dawson Creek became a regional center after the western terminus of the Northern Alberta Railways was extended there in 1932. It grew rapidly in 1942 as the United States Army used the rail terminus as a transshipment point for construction of the Alaska Highway. Dawson Creek became an RCAF station during the Second World War in September 1944. The station disbanded in March 1946. In the 1950s, the city was connected to the BC interior with a highway and a railway through the Rocky Mountains. Since the 1960s, growth has slowed, but the population of the area has increased. Dawson Creek is located in the dry, windy prairie of the Peace River country. It has a subarctic climate. Summers are warm and rainy with cool nights and low humidity. Winters are some of the coldest in British Columbia with moderate snowfall. Winter is the longest season, October to April. Summer, June through August. Spring and fall are usually short. The economy of Dawson Creek is based on four major industries: agriculture, retail, tourism, and oil and gas. Agriculture has historically been the most important, but Dawson Creek has a large tourism industry as mile zero of the Alaska Highway. Thousands drive that highway every year from Dawson Creek to Fairbanks, Alaska. The area saw occasional aircraft during the late 1930s, often associated with charter operations of Grant McConachie's United Air Transport. A field 1 mile south of the village began to be used as a landing field. This is the present site of Northern Lights College. Yukon Southern Air Transport, previously United Air Transport, had been operating out of Fort St. John since 1938. But after the Department of Transport began to improve that field in the fall of 1939, it was closed. Yukon Southern moved its wheeled aircraft operations to Dawson Creek, and temporary passenger and fuel facilities were set up. Yukon Southern Air Transport's Barclay Grow twin-engine aircraft called regularly on mail and passenger schedules from Edmonton to Whitehorse and the connecting route from Vancouver to Dawson Creek. This service to the village airfield continued until the spring of 1940, when the construction project at Fort St. John was completed and operations moved back to Fort St. John. With the attack on Pearl Harbor in December 1941, the construction of the Alaska Highway became a priority. By April 1942, road construction had begun. Dawson Creek, as the railhead of the Northern Alberta Railway, became a funnel for men, supplies, and equipment. In 1 5-week period, more than 600 freight cars moved on the railway. By May 1942, 4,720 carloads had arrived, plus thousands of men associated with the United States Army Corps of Engineers and civilian contractors who were to build the highway to Alaska as well as the airfields on the Northwest staging route. The United States Army took over the operation of the airfield 1 mile south of the community and began improvements to allow its use by the U.S. Army Air Corps for aircraft transient along the Northwest staging route. The U.S. Army Air Corps designated the airfield as Flight Strip Number 1. It was opened September 30, 1943. Ground preparation to support heavy aircraft on a 6,200-foot by 150-foot runway was completed. A single runway was later paved. The airfield was listed for emergency use, but was regularly used for logistical purposes by aircraft providing communication transport along the entire Northwest staging route. Throughout the war, the airfield was operated and maintained by the United States Army, but also used by the Royal Canadian Air Force. In October 1942, No. 6 Communications Flight was organized at Edmonton to expedite movement of supplies, mail, and personnel along the route. The flight operated two Lockheed 10A Electra, as well as a number of Norseman aircraft. By April 1943, No. 6 Communications Flight was totally swamped. The RCAF formed No. 165 Transport Squadron with Lodestar and Dakota aircraft to also supply the route's RCAF needs. Both No. 6 Flight and No. 165 Transport Squadron were frequent users of Dawson Creek's No. 1 Flight Strip. By August 1943, the RCAF had organized a freight transit route with headquarters at Dawson Creek. This unit operated a fleet of trucks from its warehouse at Dawson Creek along the entire staging route to Whitehorse and beyond. Normally requiring 9 days to make a round trip, perishable rations were expedited along the route by flying relief drivers from Dawson Creek to Fort Nelson and Dawson Creek to Fort Nelson and Watson Lake. The RCAF detachment included a barracks, a mess hall, administrative offices, a heavy-duty maintenance garage, and a warehouse. At war's end, the United States Army detachment departed Dawson Creek, leaving the airfield under control of the RCAF, which, in turn, vacated the field. By the 1950s, operation had passed to the village of Dawson Creek, which supplied fuel to aircraft and maintained the field. Dawson Creek was incorporated as a city in 1958. In 1963, it decided to relocate the airport 1.5 miles to the east, southeast of the city. The 5,000-foot runway was paved in 1966. A parallel 5,000-foot artificial lake was constructed on the north side of the runway as a seaplane landing area. The decision to build a new airport likely came from the 1960 application of Pacific Western Airlines to provide scheduled service from Edmonton to Dawson Creek. In March 1963, the Air Transport Board approved. In April 1969, Pacific Western was also granted the rights to operate a Sandspit, Prince Rupert, Prince George route. It connected via Dawson Creek to Edmonton. The author of the story for this video, Chris Waite, first flew to Dawson Creek in May 1972 in his 1949 Cessna 170A. as a newly hired pilot on the fire patrol contracts of Kelowna-based Caribou Air Charter Company, Waite would fly the company-owned Piper PA-18 Super Cub on floats from Dawson Creek Seaplane Lagoon, adjacent to that new airfield.